It's a blood stain.
Yeah, I know that's a blood stain.
It's so. Symbolic of male genital mutilation. Male genital mutilation. Forced circumcision of children.
Why you say that?
That's what it is.
I am an Israelite.
Okay.
That's offensive.
What exactly specifically?
So you understand my custom for you to say that.
What is your custom?
My custom that you have to be circumcised. Even if you are a Christian, you're supposed to be circumcised.
Well, St. Paul kind of worked that.
St. Paul can't change that word. St. Paul is a man. He's not even as high as Jesus Christ, and he knows that. So you can't change it. Go to your book. Have you got a Bible?
No.
Let's go. Let's get one for you.
I don't want to do a biblical discussion.
No, it's not a biblical discussion.
I don't want to have a discussion.
You're
about
bringing
the Bible
something
with you.
Here, which is against me
here.
And my. No. You're bringing something
you
here.
You can read this if you like.
No, but this is against my belief and my principle.
Well,
religion.
You're entitled to your belief, and I'm entitled to
So I
to
need
mine.
To correct you so you understand. You cannot say these things. That's being racist and discriminative towards I.
Well, I don't think it is.
So I could tell you that you're a racist. Because that's bad.
Well, you can say that.
So, what is mutilization? We're not muted. We just moved the foreskin forward. It's called circumcision. Circumcision, yeah?
Did you do it yourself?
No.
Someone else did it.
It's not about someone else. It's about our tradition. Can you go against our tradition? No. Can you go against your father's tradition? If it's wrong, yes. But this is not wrong. This is the way of our life. This is the way the children of Israel do this. So it's a custom. You cannot say these things. You're wrong, brother. You're out of order. You can't defend. So let me defend my case by showing you in the Bible that what is it? Romans tell you that circumcision is a must. And this is the New Testament. This is in the New Testament.
I told you I'm not going to argue about the Bible with you.
So there you go. So why is that we're fighting against circumcision? You think just circumcision because it's a circumcision in the heart and in the ear? It's just that?
But that is one argument.
But you have no argument because it's not just that. Jesus Christ, tell you
something. Okay, you know what? I don't want to do a biblical discussion about
this. You can't do a biblical discussion about that. You can't win. You can't win.
Well, fine.
Are you a Christian?
I am.
So let's debate it then.
I don't want to
let's go to your Bible and show you.
I don't want to debate the Bible with you.
Let's correct you then.
End of story. I don't want to
let's correct
the Bible.
You. So you don't believe in the word of the Lord. So Satan, I rebuke you. False teacher. Pagan. You're a paganist. You have to be circumcised. Yo, you have to be circumcision. Yeah, Romans teach you that. Paul. So he can't go against this. So as a Christian, they follow the New Testament. And the New Testament teach people that you should be circumcised. So that's a false teacher.
So easy,
everyone.
Christian
of
no talk.
Yeah, lying. Straight up, bro. We don't. Hey, we're not here to friend, you know. We're here to teach, to bring the truth. Yeah, you have to circumcise.
Even that's not a mad one.
Why? Because it's a tradition from our forefather Abraham. They're going on like they want to change it. You can't change these things. These are ignorant.